My name is Jakub Ciesielczuk, and I study at the University of Lincoln. In the light of the current global pandemic, governments, pharmaceutical companies, and researchers have been desperately looking for medications and vaccines for COVID-19. I am sure that many of you have been following the news closely on the development of those products that can help us and our families to feel more secure. What if I told you that potential material for virus medications and vaccines can be found in the remote areas of the deep seas and oceans? Marine genetic resources, which can be defined as DNA of marine species, are one of the potential sources for the novel medications. According to many studies, it is more likely to derive valuable genetic material from marine species than terrestrial species. For example, it has been estimated that around 1% of the samples from marine organisms tested in labs reveal anti-tumor potential. In comparison, in the context of terrestrial species, it is only 0.01%. Let me ask you a question. How do you think we can decide who has rights to marine genetic resources from the deep seas and oceans, of which no state has sovereign control? Should first come, first take principle be applied? Should we all as a humankind have access to them? There are international legal regimes which regulate utilization of marine genetic resources. But how can you and I can get involved in those regimes and make sure that the products from marine genetic resources reach us and our families? It appears that as individuals, our rights to participate in decision-making processes are very limited. However, our views can be represented by non-state actors, such as certain non-governmental and intergovernmental organizations. My research focuses on the nature of the participation of non-state actors in regimes regulating marine genetic resources. What I have found so far is that there are many obstacles to the participation of non-state actors in those regimes, which essentially means that we as individuals being pushed away from decision-making processes, and ultimately our views are not being taken into consideration. Imagine easy access to affordable, life-changing medication. If we continue working on developing regimes with inclusive participatory processes, this can become a reality. Thank you.